for George H.W. Bush, but Bush won. 426-11. Don't look now, but it's about to happen again. The signs are everywhere. Trump is about to win an electoral landslide. Maybe? I'm starting to think so. Political polls. National general election among independents. Trump is up 10 points. 10-point lead? Listen, I said a couple years ago, I will never vote for Donald Trump. I said in January, I will never have a gun in my home. And now, I have several. Times changed, and they changed fast. And that's why I'm saying, I reserve my right to change my mind on Trump or anybody else. Because we've got a couple months, things can absolutely change. I absolutely won't be voting for the Democrats. No way. Learned my lesson there. But I think the Democrats are a major threat right now. And while I've said many times, I am not someone to vote against someone, my vote today is for the most part a vote against the encroachment of the far left extremism. And I have no problem saying it. It's gotten worse.
And that goes to Obama. And we have to be very, very careful. And this time they're trying to do it with the whole post office thing. They'll blame it on the post office. You can see them setting it up. Be very careful and watch it very carefully. Because we have to win. This is the most important election in the history of our country. This is the most, you know, for a long period of time. I would say, well, 2016, how special was that evening? Was that the great? That was one of the great. But we have to be very, very careful, and we have to win. Our country is counting on it. This is the biggest. This is it. Our country can go on a haunting, I wouldn't say fully owned corporation, but it's certainly fully controlled, or they control them. Nobody really knows who's controlling who. But, you know, they had it on television. I remember watching it. And it was interesting. You know, you see the different states, and we say this, and we say that. The great state of Alaska, the great state of Alabama, the great state of North Carolina, the great state of all of them.
And it sounds delicious.
They had their song. Instead, they're showing the scam because too much, because they had the announcers talking. They said, I want to hear what they're saying. The delegates, I want to hear what they're saying. So I think we had to switch over to C-SPAN or to OAN or somebody. But I wanted to hear them. But I can promise you a few things. Number one, we will not be taking the word God out of the Pledge of Allegiance. Most of the people that never asked for it. Think of it. You said that you had a ballot. Here's the problem. It was just given that in the polls, believe it or not, that because the polls are trying to, that's why I respect Rasmussen, because they did well. A few of the others feel the same way. And they did well last time. Those are the ones that I look at, the ones that did well last time. And Rasmussen was very good. But if you look at it, every single vote that they have, every single vote, it's going to be looked at. A man is sitting, or a woman is sitting, waiting for nothing, watching television, has no enthusiasm. Because all enthusiasm, the polls are saying that I'm up by massive numbers, not just a little. I'm also way ahead of the economy, by the way. But I'm up by massive. And when I say I'm up, I'm talking about winning.
Everybody here is going to vote. Everybody in our base. I mean, we have a tremendous...
close up our country because it'd take it away our strength from the day. And he could choose us as VP candidate, the late great Abraham Lincoln. And you're not going to win the state of Texas if you have no oil, no guns, and no religion. Just went down by 70%. What a great president he's been. He's great. And Sleepy Joe would say, I thought about that, but nobody ever, everybody knew about favorite nations. Remember that on November 3rd, because nobody but me could ever do it. The other thing I've done, aside from very strongly protecting the Second Amendment, which was not easy. It was not easy. And by the way, they will take your guns.
But you know why? That wasn't crazy people we were dealing with. They were, you know, on the edge. Crooked Hillary was on the edge. She was on the verge. She became crazy later on when she lost. That's what she became. But these are people that are seriously radical left. Joe Biden is nothing but their puppet. He has no clue what's happening. And they're making speeches that are fake. Who wants to listen to Michelle Obama do a fake speech? You gotta have her get up there. But we're doing a real speech on Thursday. Next Thursday, she'll be listening. Doing it live from the White House. Live from the White House. And we have plenty to say. So Joe Biden and the Democrats have pledged to oppose $4 trillion of new taxes. So this is a group of people that think it's good to raise everybody's taxes. You know, in the old days, a politician with no attachments, right? The great Scott Walker is here, the governor, right?
Trees are
frosted. And Scott with no attachments, but now the whole thing, I guess it's changed. It's gone inside out. Now everyone says we're going to raise your taxes, but Republicans are lowering your taxes. We gave you the biggest tax increase. Strongest economy in the history of the world, which we did. We're going to have to do it again. We're going to have to do it again, and we're in the process of doing it. We built the greatest economy on earth, and now we're doing it again. You look at all the numbers. We're going to go over them. We've done things that nobody thought possible, right? Nobody thought possible. We've done things that nobody ever thought. You had the greatest year in the history of your state last year. Greatest year. And when you look at the numbers, you're going to have an even greater year next year, unless somebody comes in and quadruples the taxes, in which case it's called a depression, folks. It's called a depression. It's not going to happen, because what happens, Scott, I don't see it anymore. Now they go up, they look at a statue, and they say, I don't know. 10 years is a long time. They say, let's get out of here. But did you notice that 3 months ago, I saw it.
I think the race has changed dramatically in the last few weeks, and I think that now it's been very clear-cut. I go through it very quickly and get into more detail if you like, but, you know, if you are happy with the anarchy, the lawlessness, the lack of law and order, anarchists taking over city blocks, Chop, Chaz, Spaghetti, Potluck Dinner, Autonomous, Summer of Love Songs where innocent Americans die. If you're happy with the, on average, 60 or 70 people in Chicago that are shot every weekend, and the deep state about the 1%. But I always made a distinction about the 99%, same with police officers.
Right.
These are people that are putting their lives on the line every single day to protect and serve their cities, their towns, their communities. They deserve better. Joe Biden doesn't have one good word to say about tremendous job creation, jobs Jill and Barack said were never coming back. This is just the tip of the iceberg. This is the overview. And as I got into the specificity in the book, we go through all of that.
You do. In fact, I want to quote from the book several parts of it, page 60. If empowered Democrats promise to taper consumption, consider the following actions. This, 30 of them, I'm just going to read a few. Enact a new Green Deal ban, tracking patents, report on the Second Amendment, abolish or nullify the Electoral College, downsize the military, abolish private health insurance, impose a wealth tax, a debt tax, increase the top marginal rate to 70%. The list goes on and on. Is Joe Biden on board with this?
On board? He's tripled down on it. Think about that. You join this insanity, police of the enemy, reality punch from the place. Now, look at what he's now embraced just in recent weeks. And this is a phenomenon. I think it's a sign that brilliant Americans create goods and services that people want, need, and desire. That makes their money, and some of them even get both rich and they're horrible people, but you don't force people to buy your services, or you don't force people to buy your products. That has led to scientific innovation, medical breakthroughs. It has led to, let's start with the simple stuff in life. It used to not be that every home had a washer and a dryer and a microwave and a big screen TV and a refrigerator and a freezer. But all of these advancements that you look at now, I mean, are throwaway cars in this society. I owned them when I was poor, when I was starting out my adult life. And I used to fix it myself, I paint it myself, I did tune-ups, brakes, alters, starters,
you know, alternators.
Guilty as charged. Because I was paying my own way through college. I never took a penny from my parents for money. Never, I had a student loan that I paid back in full. And I worked from the time I was 12, well, 8, with paper up. And then the time I was 12, I was washing dishes by hand in a busy restaurant every Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Then I became a short-order cook, then I became a busboy, then I became a waiter, then I became a bartender. And I always had a lot of money in my pocket. Still do. It's 400 degrees, just so you know. You pick the hottest day during the day to be there. I'll change shirts and take whatever I need to. But those jobs made me a better person. Then, when I was paying my way through college, I ran out of money and I go to work. Then I went into construction. I started painting houses. Then I started learning how to hang wallpaper. Then I started doing reconstruction work. Then I did roofing. Fell off 3 stories of the roof. Hit the ground, became a conservative. Got a little sense of well, this part of my arm from here down was dangling, separate and I called the radio man.
I used your diamond.
70, 12, 14 dead. How many children will be shot? We've got a 1-year-old killed in Brooklyn, New York, an 8-year-old killed in Atlanta, Georgia, a 7-year-old killed in Chicago, a 19-year-old young man. I interviewed his father, Morris, Lorenzo Anderson Sr., his namesake Jr., killed in the Chop Chad summer love zone. These kids are never coming back. We're losing thousands of young kids. So how did these states that have adopted their mini versions, who they wanted to be American here, is this your judgment the worst thing that will be worth the price of admission on steroids and human growth hormone? Because they think they got this locked up, but if they have to, to me, I'm worried if this is now where indoctrination in our school system has gotten us, that they no longer hide their radicalism, and they've convinced younger generations center left is where America goes, but it's really hard left. Donald Trump will be, at best, buying America time. Now, how do you fix that? Because it's got to be a process of education, a process of understanding freedom.
Conway is this very prominent anti-Trump figure, and then here's his daughter trying to be just like him. It's like when you see a dad and, you know, he's like riding his bike and the kids with him trying to be, it's nice, you know, it's nice to see the you know, family getting along. Now, I'm sure many people would have preferred if she was trying to be like her mom, but look, I get it, man. She looks up to her dad. She wants to be like her dad. She's probably got friends that rag on her about Trump, so she wants to be like her dad. And it's just, there you go, okay? She's revolting against her mom for whatever reason, and looking up to her dad, it's fine. My bigger issue is that the internet turned it into this salacious debacle, and it results in this just like, it's reality TV. It's absolutely reality TV. I'm glad to see the Conways are getting their family in order, and I'm glad to see that they're stepping away. And, you know, my respect. They say her videos come less than 24 hours after Kellyanne resigned. George and Kellyanne are both Republicans, but while Kellyanne worked for Trump and his senior counsel, George, an attorney, is one of the president's most vocal and pointed critics. Kellyanne announced Sunday that she would depart her administration role at the end of this month. A family, to be less drama, more mama. Shortly after the announcement, Claudia was once again on TikTok stating their parents were going to get divorced, but have now called it off to keep her from getting emancipated. Wow. She has also accused her father of not caring about her and not knowing her middle name, and said her mother has been physically abusive her whole life. There it is. There it is. She says her mom was abusive. I don't know if that's true, but that shows me why she doesn't like Kellyanne and why she doesn't like Trump. Because her mom worked for the president, she resents her mom. And check it out. When she's talking about her dad doesn't care about her, doesn't even know her middle name. Dude, that's...
Hey, welcome to GCU. You're in Loop Country now.